We've done many art shows through CrailTap, but there's so many photographers involved in the brands, but we've never had like a pure photo show.
CrailTap has six brands involved. There's Girl, Chocolate, 4-Star, Royal, Lakai, and CrailTap, the online magazine.
In its inception, we thought of it as an online magazine.
It was kind of like the internet was still wasn't like established in skateboarding yet. They were kind of like making these digital zines.
It was pretty early on for that kind of concept. And we used to do like issues, do a full web page until it just started to be like a regularly updated website.
CrailTap's definitely been the first of its kind. You can't really call it a company or a brand, but it was just this thing that the people involved with it said, hey, we got something special. There's a group of people that are special that want to share the same ideas and have the same sort of influences and the same sense of humor. So how can we kind of like not brand that, but make it something cool? And that's CrailTap. You know, it's all the brands, but it's just really the ethos of the entire bubble.
We've done many art shows through CrailTap, but there's so many photographers involved in the brands, but we've never had like a pure photo show. We already knew the players that were going to be involved. It's the guys involved with the brands that shoot photos.
We decided who was going to do it, who was going to be in the show, and then everyone kind of made a selection of their own photos, and then kind of Sam and I looked at everything as a whole and tried to find the story within everyone's selections.
There's probably like a couple more people I would have liked to have in it, but it was kind of short notice and a lot of people couldn't get their photos together. So this is the show of CrailTap resident photographers that could get their shit together.
Not all of it, but a lot of it revolves around skating, even if it's like the periphery. In skateboarding, I've always been a fan of the people that don't just shoot like the tricks, but shoot the things that are happening around it. Getting to travel and stuff and going on skate trips and everything, we get to go to some pretty interesting places, so I like to sort of take landscapes, the places we are, just try to document everything.
I always split photography into the two camps. You either make a photo, you're creating something that doesn't exist and you're making a photo, or you're taking a photo. And so it's interesting, I've experimented with both types of photography, but for the past 10 years ago, I find myself more taking a photo than making a photo. So it's more of a documentary, sort of you have to be there, you're not really faking anything. More of you stumble upon something and take the photo.
I've been shooting point-and-shoot photos for ages. I got into shooting manual cameras 12 years ago or so. Super into rangefinder, medium format stuff. That's like what all my photos are. They're all with the same camera, 6-7. I'm super psyched to put my photos on display because I don't really get a chance to do that. It's really cool to see them printed big and framed nice. I'm psyched.
I was 18 years old. That's when I first really got into it. I always wanted it to be skateboarding, but I figured out kind of early that shooting skateboarding is a whole different animal. Through that learning curve, I realized, oh, well, there's a whole other side of photography that's interesting, and I just kind of decided to pursue that as opposed to like shooting skateboarding. Every show that's around like our industry tends to focus on skating, you know? Not that that's bad, that's why we're all here. We all love it. But there are these other influences that everyone, including skaters, have that no one ever really knows about.
I've been shooting photos for years, just on my own. Like, everyone just shoots photos. It wasn't like a thing where everyone started shooting photos together. It's not like skating where people all skate together. It's just like we all happen to have this other interest we could all put together like this. I chose photos kind of based on what I thought everyone else would do too, just so it would fit into the story of everything. Portraiture, a little bit of skateboarding, and then a little bit of walking around, street stuff, whatever.
Aaron Meza, he's the head of our video department. He's been filming skateboard videos since early 90s. A lot of people might not like know him as a photographer because he's always with a video camera, but I knew that he has like some old gems. I knew he'd have some. So when I hit him up, he was like super psyched to dig in the crates and pull some out.
Some of them I've never seen their photos, so it makes it a really rad show. Like Aaron Meza, I've known him for 15, 16 years and worked with him for about 10 years. And I always think of him as a video guy. When he was on this roster of a photo show, I was excited to see what he was gonna come out with and what he was gonna have here. And his photos are awesome. That photo of Stevie Williams in Paris is amazing, and that boat taxi cab driver in Egypt is awesome. Gotta get Meza shooting more often and carrying his camera around again.
I was the editor of a magazine for like 5 years, and at that time I had film and processing like budget. I had a, you know, an account at a lab, so I was getting free film. So all my photos in this show are actually from that window of time where I had free film accounts.
Rick Shooting the Gun, that's like 2003. That girl or Trail Tap, they used to have an annual company camping trip, and it was called Camp Whatevs. Party, have fun, document it, and just basically rage. We've been playing poker all night, drinking all night, smoking all night, and everyone got up in the morning. Someone had a high-powered Pelican, and people were just shooting it. But Rick, with like anything that could like hurt somebody by matter of like explosion, he's just all about it. He just grabbed it and was like hitting this target, just boom, 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 just fixated on it. And so everyone just kind of like gathered around. Fuck, he's fucking that camp up. That's the kind of stuff that happens. You just got these people that all actually like to be around each other. So if you're lucky, you can like kind of step back and like shoot it. Get some of those moments.
I really like portraiture, and so I've got a photo of Spike Jonze. It was while he was making Where the Wild Things Are, so he's wearing the big Wild Things feet. It's just black and white, real simple, against his office wall. He just put those feet on willingly, and I just shot a Pentax 6-7 photo right there with natural light, and it's a great image. I'm proud of that one.
There's an image of Robbie Russo in the neck brace. It's hard to say it's a favorite because we were actually pretty worried for him. He got so brutally devastated on a ramp, colliding with somebody. Flew through the air like a rag doll. We were just in the lobby of the hotel and he just came walking in with the neck brace. So it's kind of candid that I caught Carol coming in to give him a hug, just looking right at me. I like that image a lot.
Skateboarding takes creativity in the first place.
So you have to be creative on your board, there's style to it. There's so many skateboarders that are amazing photographers, painters, illustrators, artists. I mean, it's great, it goes hand in hand. It's like if you're creative on your board, a lot of times it rubs off into sketchbooks and notebooks, and it's been great to see so many creative types.
Most skateboarders have some sort of artistic outlet. They go hand in hand. I think it's pretty cool that we have a show all by skateboarders. There's not actually any skateboard photos in it. It all clicks. It's all part of one art form.
I think they're all talented in different ways, and the way they see things and the way they take photos. I think it's rad for them to get together and do a show like this, because we've always celebrated the artists, the graphic design artists.
When you get to do all this stuff, you want to document it, just like how people want to document anything in a way, but we just get opportunities to document sort of things that are more interesting. I mean, traveling, and there's a lot of just people who are interesting characters in our world, I guess. There's just so much funny stuff happening or interesting stuff happening. It would be stupid not to take pictures of it almost. No, no, no.